to talk about five habits that increase your income. It's your desire, it's your objective to earn more in life. Whatever you are earning now, you want to step up on earning so that you can do more for yourself and for others, and then contribute more to the society with the much you've been able to keep back or amass in fortune. So there are habits that tend to decrease our earning, and there are habits that tend to increase our earning as well. So as you view, I want to show you what it takes to increase your earning. Number one habit is stick to your goals. Set realistic goals. These goals should correspond with how much money you want to earn over a period of time. It could be a period of a year, financial goal or objective. You have to set your business goal or set your work goal and get set to stick to your goal. The goals you have set are the only things that you set your mind on or set your heart upon to achieve or accomplish. Don't be distracted by how much money Mr. A or Mr. B or whoever is making. Stick to the goals you have set for yourself, because before you set the goals, you had planned out, you had researched, you had known what these goals will bring your way or bring back in terms of fortune. So once you've set your goals, pay deaf ears to all kind of distractions or beats, no matter how lucrative they seem to be. Habit number two, do a few things. Don't do too many things. Rather do things that you are super good at. Don't do stuff for money. Don't do things for money. Do things that you do from your interest. When you do things from interest, your passion will flourish. You will have the will for it, and there will be a drive to accomplish things around that sphere. So do things from your interest. Then concentrate on doing a few things. A few things that you are good at. Even when you wake up from sleep, you can still do them. So don't do too many things at a time. Spend your time doing a few that you are good at, and you are likely to be more productive. And that corresponds with how much more income you earn daily, monthly, or annually. Habit number three, disciplined work attitude. You should have a disciplined work attitude, because this will correspond with how much more you earn or how much less you earn, whether daily, monthly, or annually. There are three things that make discipline work attitude in our scope. The first is be prompt. There should be time given to you to appear or show up. Be prompt. And if you're working for yourself, fix time and be right on schedule. The next thing is beat deadlines. You should set deadlines for your work. If you are self-employed, you're working for someone, there is a time frame, time given within which a particular duty should be accomplished or, yes, completed and delivered. So work within that time frame. Don't allow the time to elapse without you being able to beat the deadline. So always beat the deadline. Then the third thing is be at your best. What I mean by being at your best is always pursue to give out with excellence. Dispose your duties or discharge your duties with excellence. Pursue to give out the best every time you are given any job to do. Just give out the best. Make sure you perform at your best. If you can't perform at your best, then do nothing at all. The best thing to do is to give out your best. That corresponds with how much income you'll attract. Habit number four, don't stop with brand. Brand is what people buy. Brand is what people pay for. So as much as possible, don't stop rebranding. Rebrand your product, rebrand your services. This involves innovation, sacrifice, persistence. These three are very, very important when we talk about rebranding your products. If you want to rebrand yourself, you need to give attention to innovation. Pay attention to your guts. Be intuitive. Know what should be the next brand of service. On rebranding, you don't only rebrand your products, you rebrand yourself. Those things that bring you into demand, if what you do is service you render, what are those things that will bring you into demand? Place high value on branding yourself. And once you do, check yourself out over time, update as much as and as fast as can be, given the trend that it's going on around the corner at the time. So rebrand yourself. when you rebrand yourself, you earn more. Branding yourself could mean polishing yourself, acquiring more skills, or improving on the current skills or skill sets that you have already. Next brand of product, its outlook, and what's catchy about it, what's interesting about it, what's fascinating about it that consumers will fall in love with and would eagerly pay you or reward you for it. The better your brand, the more income you attract. So you increase your earning by rebranding your products. The fifth habit is keeps on. What I mean by keeps on is what is popularly known as savings. As you earn, remember to withhold some. Keep some. Don't spend everything no matter what happens. So don't spend everything. Keep some. And as you keep some, invest some. Save some. Investment will compound over time and you become wealthier. There are some investments that pays heavily in returns. So pick your investments wisely and invest your savings as you keep some in reserve. So these are five attitudes that will make you step up on your income or step up on your earning as you put them to work. I'm very sure that you shall step up in your earning. As I bring us to conclusion, the five habits are: stick to your goals, do a few things, disciplined work attitude, don't stop rebranding, and lastly, keep some. These are the secrets that a few folks at the top of the financial world or fortune world know and apply, and these enhance their earnings daily.